So now we're fully into phase two of the season. We're almost fully into it. There's a couple of stragglers out there still playing non-district games, but district play starts for everybody just about. And that leads us to a few big games. Doing a feature on Marlin for Friday. They play at Italy. That's a big game to start district. Probably from our point of view, we can say it's the district championship game right out of the box. Crawford versus Hamilton is a pretty important district game as Hamilton looks pretty good in that loop. And then I think a real sort of defining game will be Cameron-Yoe versus Academy, because Academy has shown themselves to be right there some of the time. They're 5-1. They beat McGregor last week. But Cameron-Yoe just obliterated Rottendale to start district. So they're 2-4 now and gaining steam. What do you like out of that bunch?
Man, I think you picked three pretty good games right there. I mean, I feel like all of them have the chance to be entertaining. I would say you would not rule out any team in either of those three matchups. I mean, I think there's probably some favorites, you know, with good reason. I would be a little surprised if Hamilton beat Crawford, but as you mentioned, the Bulldogs are playing well. But I do feel like Crawford is the class of that district. It is kind of crazy to think that, you know, here in the district opener, you basically have the district championship game, but I agree with you. I think that's what shapes up in that Mart Italy game. Marlin, not Mart. You know, give a lot of credit to Ruben Torres for what he's done in his first year there at Marlin. You know, a couple years ago, it was pretty ragged out there. I mean, and the Bulldogs are playing well. They have such tradition and pride in Marlin and in that football program and in athletics in general, and have had some good teams. We know some of the struggles that the town has had and the school district and stuff. But, you know, like I said, I'm really impressed with the job he's doing there in his first year, because to me, that first year for a high school football coach, especially when they haven't been on staff before, usually it's a transition year. It's a get to know you kind of year. And you don't really expect that much. But if Marlin can go out and, you know, maybe win this game against the Gladiators, go on and win a district title, that's a heck of a first year for Ruben Torres.
Yeah, that's almost Jinx Tucker type stuff, isn't it?
It is. It is. That'd be a fun conversation to have. Chad's, of course, referring to our Jinx Tucker trophy, which is similar to the Gordon Wood trophy that the Texas High School Football Hall of Fame puts out, kind of takes into account overcoming adversity and things like that. So
an endorsement as that game, as the district championship game right off the bat, looks like on paper the next best team in that district is actually 2-3.
Yeah, it's not a particularly strong district. Besides Marlin, Italy, and Axto, you've got Dawson, Kearns, and Cayuga. So
those three teams have, I think, two or three wins between them.
Two wins. They're 2-13 between the three of them. So yeah, I mean, it's not a powerhouse district. It is not the district of doom.